believe that Jews would kill Christians to mix their blood to bake the holy matzahs on Passover? Is that your belief?
What would be your most immediate reaction if you were told your next door neighbor had been using the blood of children for baking bread and biscuits? Would you immediately grab a baseball bat? Or would you ask some questions first? Here is an inside look about Jewish blood libels, a dark anti-Semitic history for a people who deserved a little better. Origin of the blood libel. It has its roots in anti-Semitism.
I can breathe. Please, the name of it. I can breathe here.
Bro, get in the car, man.
I will.
Get in the car.
I can't move.
And is a fruit of discrimination and racism, resulting in many Jewish deaths. The blood libel, which is also interpreted as the blood accusation, is a belief that Jews kill people, especially Christian children, and consume their blood. The origin of this brutal myth dates back to the 12th century in the eerie outer woods of Norwich, a city in England. A local, going about his business one cold morning, came across the lifeless body of a familiar face, a young boy called William. Shocked, he drew closer only to realize that he had suffered strange wounds to his head, hands, and torso. He immediately blew the alarm. A monk called Thomas of Monmouth, the boy's uncle, took up the charge and labeled it ritual murder, pointing to the Jews as the perpetrators of the heinous crime. This was not an isolated charge, but a chain reaction from a prevailing thought that the Jews were the ones who crucified Jesus, and so deductively may have already developed a knack for killings. This spread like wildfire. Further down the video, we will look at reasons some may term as ridiculous, for which many people, for a long time, believed was the reason the Jews went after the blood of Christian children. Since that time, Jews were blamed for the deaths and disappearance of several Christian children, and even one time, a Christian priest.
And so in Europe, if there was a young woman or a young man who turned up dead, and there was any way to blame a Jew, that would have happened.
Two significant things happened anytime a blood libel charge came up. The first was that the Jews would be tortured and beaten until they confessed to being the culprits of these crimes, even if they were not. The situation was presented as though their confession was the only remedy to the immense pain they were going through as a result of the torture. But the moment they confessed, they were killed. The second thing that characterized these blood libel incidences was the cults and followings that sprang up due to the victims of these alleged killings. The victims of blood libels were usually considered martyrs. A cult would spring up from their death, and these people would incite the blood accusations, spread it, and spearhead the massacre of thousands of innocent Jews. Some of the victims of the blood libels who became famous martyrs include Simon of Trent, William of Norwich, and Hugh of Lincoln.
The cult of Simon of Trent was only abolished, officially abolished, in 1965, on the exact day as the Nostra Aetate Declaration.
There are yet more stories and events to be unfolded, and they can fall right in your lap with a click on the subscribe button. Don't miss our next revealing upload for anything. Hit the subscribe button now. The motivation for accusation. There are quite a few reasons proposed as to why the Jews were killing these children and had developed this insatiable desire for blood. Back in 400 BC, a Greek text explaining the relation between health and religion indicated that there are four types of liquids in every individual: blood, yellow bile, phlegm, and black bile. Dr. William McLeod of the Faculty of History of Science and Medicine from the University College, London, speaking on the text, explained that these four liquids, if balanced in a person, showed that the person was healthy. He quotes, 500 years later, Galen very selectively chose between the Hippocratic texts and decided, this one text that identifies these four humors is an authentic text of Hippocrates. He went on to explain that these four types of liquids in the body were used to determine the four major types of personalities there are. Those who had more blood were the sanguines and the healthiest. Those who had more of the yellow bile were the choleric. Those who had a predominant amount of phlegm were the phlegmatics. And those who had black bile, you guessed right, were the melancholics and the most unhealthy. He quotes, each one of the arguments that the sanguine person is healthy, The melancholic is unhealthy is inevitably built around inequality and arbitrary value. Weaving this into the fabric of the 13th to 15th century society at the time, a strange case was made that the Jews, labeled as a black-biled melancholic group, had an abnormal condition that caused their men to menstruate like women. It was considered a curse for their participation in the crucifixion of Jesus. The blood libel was then explained away as the act of the Jews to try to make up for their draining blood and evil curse. The only remedy for this curse, to have the blood of Jesus running through them, as propounded by the Christian community at the time. This could be done by converting to Christianity and partaking in the Eucharist. If this sounded ridiculous to you as well, hit the thumbs up button. Apart from this, many people believed that the Jews used the blood for such things as an inclusive and necessary ingredient in baking their unleavened bread called matzah during their Passover festival. It was also believed that the Jews either drank the blood of these murdered Christian children directly or mixed them with the 4 cups of wine they partaken during their Passover Seder celebrations. Some even believed that they baked pastries called hamantaschen during Purim, the Jewish holiday, with the blood of these children. A costly myth. The blood libel and other myths, such as well poisoning, conspiracy theories of world domination, and other anti-Semitic theories have fueled and driven the Jews into very dark times. It cost several lives and the loss of billions of dollars in property damage over the ages.
Millions of people were convinced or coerced to help systematically murder 6 million innocent men, women, and children.
There has been the Holocaust.
But we do know that many methods that enabled this unprecedented mass genocide, known as the Holocaust, are being practiced today.
The expulsion from Spain, Germany, and Europe, over 1,300 pogroms committed in Ukraine alone, and so much more violence perpetrated against them, some yet to be accounted for. Until now, despite overwhelming evidence, do you know that some people still don't believe the Holocaust actually happened? Check out this video on the current development of tensions rising between nations in our time. World War III coming danger everywhere. Who will support whom? Scholars have documented that between the 12th and 16th centuries, over 100 blood libels were recorded, which resulted in the death of hundreds of thousands of Jews at the time. Blood libel is a myth, which means they never have any evidence to back their claims. There were cases like that of a Jewish rabbi who was almost beaten to death for the disappearance of a little girl in 1928. The girl was later found alive and healthy.
The blood libel is depressingly common in European history. It was unknown in the United States until this incident happened in 1928.
This has been quite a historical journey. Let's get to the comments section and know your thoughts on the development of these events. See you in our next upload.